Positive, that's good. Yeah. Hey, what inspired you the most for this album? What message do you want to get out there?
The message is awake, you know. Speaking mentally, you know, spiritually. Physically, we are awake every day. But mentally, you know, sometimes the truths are certain things that we're supposed to see and acknowledge. We don't see them, you know what I mean, in life. Until, like now, we're in a time of what them say, depression. You know what I mean, where everyone is suffering, struggling, you know. Big business a struggle, small business struggling. One life is in turmoil, just through survival, you know. So this album now, you know, for me, I had to bring a new refreshing sound within the reggae music, you know, which is a blend between the roots and the upbeat kind of sound, you know, because we have also a couple different songs on the album, mixed with hip-hop drums, but everything else is reggae, you know, so you get a blend. You're not getting no water in, you're getting music, yeah. You know. So in this time now we say awake, you know, because there's no better time to wake than the present, you know. There's one God, one name, one destiny, yes. One people, you know. So that for me is just a cultural, you break down all barriers, yeah. With that. Yeah. Living in England, living in America, living in Jamaica, the way you live. You know, so we live right now, we're there right now, we live right now, yeah. You know, right where we are right now, we live right now, yeah. You know what I mean? So everything is here. You know?
True.
Yeah.
It's really true.
Comfort is right there. You
know? Yeah. Hey, knowing that your father, the legendary Robert Nesta Marley, and your late grandmother, Mrs. Brooker, have been an inspirational guidance to you in your life, what has that meant to you? Which are the biggest lessons for having that kind of guidance?
Biggest lesson for me? Well, first of all, we grew up with guidance, you know, we grew up with the guidance. So from the barn, and now they say my father's a Rasta man, and we listen to music, and I get that positive vibration from the music. From there, the mind is on that, you know. Yeah, man, from me at five, I tell my mother, I say, yeah, lax now. And she said, school, which is, that's how it goes, you know. But that's how it goes, the culture is this there, it's building, yeah. You know, so for me, and then the ancestors, you know, the ancestors, because they are our ancestors, you know, forefathers and mothers, you know, so it's a very spiritually energetic, you know, now that they've moved on to the brighter, you know,
yeah.
Brighter light,
yeah.
You get back the reflection of spirituality.
Things ain't cool anymore. Things ain't cool anymore. Things ain't cool anymore. We can't be fooled no more. Can't be fooled no more. Things ain't cool anymore. Things ain't cool anymore. Things ain't cool anymore. We can't be fooled no more. We can't be fooled no more.
How do you think we can break the barriers of the doubtful and show them that this is actually a positive way? You know?
Because you have to open your mind, you have to open your heart. You have to open your mind and open your heart. Yeah. You know? You know? That's like, you know, you're walking on the street and you see a homeless person. Some people just, ooh, walk past. They don't want to dirty their white pants. You know? They're not very open. So, open your mind and your heart, you know? And everything will come in, all what is right, you know? So when you're wickedness, you don't need no heart for wickedness. You don't have to be open. Wickedness is a selfish thing. Yeah. If you're for your brothers and for your next door neighbor and for the man who live way down the street that you don't know, you're not going to go down there and rob him. Because for the wickedness, which is that closed up mentality, is making you, you want that from him. But how did he accumulate it? Through hard work, you know? So, yeah, it's open, you know, I'll be open. Yeah,
be open.
Yeah, man.
All right, now that we're talking about the wickedness of Babylon, which fight do you think is the harder, the physical one or the mental one?
Right now, two of them put together now.
Yeah,
yeah,
they are.
Yeah, physical and spiritual, you know. I have, you know, suffering physically, financially. Yeah, people that struggle spiritually. Being, you know, before you just say God, then God, alright. If you say God, then your whole life, your whole thinking, everything have to change.
Yeah.
Speaking back to what we're speaking about, loving your brother.
Yeah.
If you love God, and God create everyone, and everything, even the butterfly, the bee, everything, you know. So who is you to go and, you know, whether kill or whatever you do, or fight against your brother, or talk bad against your brother, you know? So to me, that's bad, you know? And when you're up, you must help ones come up.
Yeah.
That's what happened too. Some people up and don't. So for me, it's a humanitarian, you know? We don't watch nothing, you know? From the low to the high,
yeah.
You know? Because who are we? And just children of the Almighty.
What an up.
Yeah.
What an up.
We've got to.